issues at the time. She did have a series earlier, before her Big Daddy series, when she focused on like the Freedom Riders movement. But this movement of Big Daddy is more focused on U.S. imperialism and critiquing Western hegemony and the impacts on other countries abroad. So specifically, these were painted during a time when the Vietnam War was really big. So she's trying to criticize like the U.S.'s involvement in the Vietnam War, but specifically the sort of culpability of these sort of men like her father, so these sort of working class white American men who became complacent and sort of just believed the U.S. government and sort of had this desire to create violence abroad. And so it's also very much so a criticism of like masculinity and its use in creating violence and engendering violence abroad. Specifically because of this reference to Theodore Roosevelt, who was the president during a time in which the U.S. became more involved in countries abroad like Cuba or Puerto Rico and started to dominate, like express control over these regions. So interestingly, the name itself, Pax Americana, which means peace, American peace, and sort of demonstrates this sort of idea of global peace involving the U.S. is sort of interesting, and she definitely calls attention to the sort of hypocrisy and irony of that statement. Where during this time in which many people in America were able to enjoy certain privileges and luxuries while at the time they were creating this violence abroad. I think some of the symbols she uses are very interesting, like the sort of hat, the sort of helmet on the top of his head is also sort of invisible. So it sort of demonstrates, I feel like there's a lot of different ways to interpret it, but to me it sort of demonstrates this sort of like complacency. But I think there's a lot of different other ways to interpret it as well, so feel free to kind of think about it in your own way. I do really like these different colors of blues. It's a very striking shade of blue, and I think when I first saw it, it really struck my attention. The sort of contrast between this like bright ultramarine blue and how it also looks different, and that he's wearing this flag on him. And I think the bulldog definitely captures my attention as well, because it looks like a very, I don't know, it's a very disturbing sort of image of a dog. It's not really a dog I'd want to play with, but it definitely seems very aggressive and masculine of an animal. And that it's sort of sitting on his lap, to me, demonstrates this sort of power. And definitely this whole pose, he has this very powerful pose. And if you see how it's situated in the museum, he definitely kind of leans above you as you're walking by. And it's not the most pleasant work of art, but it definitely brings up a lot of questions and really makes you think about the world today, because even though it was created in the 70s, it sort of makes you question the US's role today or other countries' role today in sort of continuing this legacy of imperialism abroad. So yeah, I think I really like this piece, and a lot of other works by Mae Stevens are really excellent as well. So I would recommend, if you have the chance, to see this in the museum or also look up other artworks by her. So thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it.